Today we have the webinar Atlas Series Controllers. Let me introduce me. I am Jose Pacheco from ZK Europe, and this presentation we can find all the information about these devices that has very very wonderful functions and makes a lot of simple the control access control with these controllers, because has some features that help us in these devices that you don't need, for example, an external software, because these controllers has his own software in beef. And well, this is the main screen when we access to this software that is a web browser. Okay, Atlas Series is from ZKTeco. It's the first solution web browser based. This is a Linux platform access control solution. This access control system has delivering faster and easier setup and scalability, allowing customers to achieve high performance with lower installation. This means that we don't need too much devices with this, only our controller, our readers, and using the relays for open doors or any devices that you can have attached with this controller. So you can control many different kind of devices or logs. You can use magnetic entrance. Has many different kind of installations. And the maintenance offsite programming cost is lower because you have all in these controllers. Okay, it's very simplified everything. Atlas is the first ever controller panel with embedded software and with RFID and biometric technologies. We have two kind of Atlas series. And this black, for example, is just RFID, and the gray one is have the capability too of biometric, also RFID. At the same time, providing highest security level to any installation and protect people, property, and assets. Atlas system speaks for itself when installing and using. It's easy to use without too many instructions, just navigating for a web browser anywhere in the world or using the mobile app. This mobile app is also with the Android platform or iOS. Okay, this is very easy to install, and commission requiring minimum training for that. Atlas advantage: trust security with no complications, access control system without complexity design for medium size environments to provide full personal tracking, user using RFID and fingerprint recognition in safe system at safe time. Okay, that's what I'm talking before. We can use with your configuration and in the Atlas, you can use for every door. Okay, many kind of standards. You can use, for example, just a fingerprint, or you can use the RFID. Also, you can use with a PIN code. I have some readers that have the capability to have the RFID reader, also codes. So you can use numerical codes, RFID, fingerprint, at the same time, everything, the three kind, or you can switch with this kind of features more in this moment is a PowerPoint presentation. Then we are going to have a technical example for this Atlas, how this works, and you can see how can you configure and set up these controllers, and also see all the capability of the function with this software. Scalability. This Atlas series, you can use it just up to 84 doors. Okay, adding a maximum of 20 secondary controllers. This means we always need to have a primary controller. You can use for make this multiple of 84 doors. You can have 21 controllers with 4 doors each one. So the primary going to control 4 doors and the 20 secondary going to control, if this secondary are of 4 doors, then you can have 80 doors with the 20 secondary controllers and the 4 doors of the primary, that is 84 doors. Okay, you can mix it and use 1 door, 2 doors, or 4 doors. That's the 3 models that we have, okay, with 1 door, 2 doors, and 4 doors. Simplicity. Atlas uses the C5 and Invio 5 controller panels. It's based on this, with ZKTeco's factory installed software, and easy to learn and easy to use browser-based application. In our past webinars, my partners and the webinars that it's coming to, they're going to explain how is ZK biosecurity, BioAccess, and another software that we have available for you. So this is based with it's a mix of all our solutions, just embedded in one. Okay. This is Atlas. And remote accessibility, Atlas can be managed through any PC, device or PC internet enabled or mobile app. So you can manage employee credentials and access anytime, anywhere. And this mobile app has the feature for administrator only. Okay, you can't use this mobile app for example users, because you can give the credentials or permissions to these users, because it's just for administrative purpose. Cost saving. Atlas provides time and cost saving installation process as no server or license is required. In this case, when you bought a Atlas controller, you have a license that with this license you can have up to 25 doors. Okay, this license, it's coming with the first device that you buy, and in this case you can use, for example, if the primary is for 1 door, you can get another 24 doors. So this is mixing. In this case, on 24. Okay. Then the next license you need is, for example, up to 25 doors. The next license is for 50 doors, and if you need get the up to 84 doors, then you can you need to buy another license that brings you the capability to add this 20 secondary controllers and all the capability of doors. So also with the mobile app, you can do with the first license that comes with your Atlas, you can have 1 user. So if you need up to 5 users for administrative purpose, then you must need to buy this license too. This installation simplify the programming for a faster installation and setup of your access control system from anywhere. That's told before, the controller has all the relays, all the readers in. For example, for any each door, you can have an entrance reader and an exit reader. Or you can use only entrance mode. Okay, you can use exit button, for example. Well, we are going to see this. Atlas features, building web application with primary, secondary structure, not software guide. This is embedded inside of the Atlas. This is labeled up to 84 doors, maximum 21 devices, 5,000 users capacity, area monitoring, anti-passback, lockdown, linkage, and all advanced access control features are available. Integrated graphic mapping, email notifications, role-based identity management with flexible settings for different users with different access levels, mobile app available for iOS and Android platform, built-in PoE and Wi-Fi capability reduces installation cost. This Atlas, you can use only your network wire and using a PoE switches or injectors, you can bring the power supply to these controllers, and you don't need an external power supply. Also, these controllers, you can use it with an external AC power supply, also batteries, and this controller has the alarms for these features. If, for example, you have a power supply loss, then the Atlas has the pop up the alarm and tell us that we have a power supply issue, and then you can use the and automatically mode the batteries. Okay, and if the batteries fails, also we have an alarm for this event too. The features, web-based application. This screen, we can see the home of this controller. The powerful and intuitive web management application integrated into the controller. All you need is a web browser. There is no PC software to install and maintain. This will save your installation engineer a lot of time and keep the web management application isolated and safe from potentially conflicting applications. So you don't need a specific server or a PC for manage these controllers, this access control, because like this is in VIP, but this makes so easy to work with these controllers. Features, password reset. These controllers, when you start the configuration of this, you have the possibility to register these controllers. So this is very important, because with this registration of the controller Atlas series, you can have access to a lot of advantage. And also, it's mandatory to make this kind of just the kind of features like password reset. We are having so many issues with on some customers that when he began to set up the controllers, they put on a password very restrictive, very segregated, and this controller doesn't show this password. When you are entering this password, the controller doesn't have the capability to show you what are you typing. A physical demonstration that I want to do at the end of this presentation, then you can see how this is works. And when you end the configuration, then you can have the registration form, and then when you register these controllers, then with your email, you can have the reset password function. Okay, so you don't need any another support for this feature. In case of you lose the password and the email option is not working, then you need to contact us and create a ticket on our system, and then we can help you. Features. It's compatible with printers. This software also has the function of you can design your own cards, presentations. You can make backgrounds, enter the name of the users, or you can create that like you want. So if you use printer cards, then you can connect it directly to the Atlas controllers and print it. This is compatible with WIGAN and OSPD readers. Okay, and you can use the readers for these controllers. We have the specific readers. You can see on my webcam. This is the fingerprint and RFID reader. So this reader is is using the RS-485 protocol. Okay, and this needs to be OSPD too. Okay, also you can use, for example, KR readers in a second, this one. And also these readers is WIGAN protocol. So you can define the WIGAN format cards, card format, and use you can use 26 bit, 34, 35, 37, 50 bit, and also so many. You can define your own WIGAN card format, for example, for HID readers. The mobile application is an example of this application. Okay, this app is you only need to. I'm going to show you. Okay. This is our mobile app. Okay, so you need to scan a QR code, then the device must ask for the server address. You can put your Atlas controller with a DNS server, for example, no IP, DNS, DNS servers. There's a lot of DNS servers that you can use, and then you can be able to use this app. Okay, then you need to type your username and password, and with the security of the QR code, this is for just only use. So the user that you register in your mobile, then even if someone have the access to a QR code, the Atlas doesn't give the permission to log in. Okay, and the system going to decline this petition because this QR code and security was used. So this is very, very important. After you can log in with the app, then you can be you can see the users. For example, you can register cards or PIN or biometrics. You have the Atlas series biometrics. Okay. You can see also the events, status of system. You can see also if somebody is connected using the web browser or another mobile client, if you have the license for more than one user. You can see the backups. Okay, this system creates automatically, has the automatically feature for create backups that with all the information, all the database of your controllers, and record three backup inside the in his memory inside, and rewrite these backups. So then you can have the capability to recover these backups and download to your PC, and maybe monthly you can have some backup and not lose any backup that the Atlas do by itself. Okay, but this I want to show you, of course, too. This is the part of the mobile application. Also, the The controller has an online help always available in the with the system. This help is it's in English only, but it's very helpful. Have all the features, capability, feature configuration, or if you have any doubts, you can use this help, or you can open a ticket too, and we can help you with any issue. The characteristic features about this controller has emergency codes. Emergency codes, you can use it for example, global lockout, global emergency lock, alarm management, dual spins, emergency codes, and meeting reporting. For example, if you have any issue in your building or the place where it's installed this access control, you can use the emergency codes with a reader in code. The Atlas code make a global lockout or open with a global emergency unlock for a free exit. Okay, this is mandatory in access control services has these features available. I also have the firmware update. This is very easy to use. As soon as we have some new firmware to our controllers, then we can send you by email or we can create a newsletter where you can see a new release is available. So you just need to get this file to your PC and then upload it to the controller, and using the network of the controllers where you have connected every Atlas, then you can update all the controllers, primary and secondary. Also have you the feature of holidays. Okay, you can create your own holidays for any country, any place. So you know, every country, every place has its own holidays. So you can create up to 8 types of holidays, special days, with different color, label, and calendar layout makes holiday settings more intuitive. Flexible user settings. More flexible user settings for different needful privileges, like access doors in lockdown mode and the passback exempt. Also extended door times. This privilege you can give it to any user, to all users, or just to the user that you need, or if you don't need to give this privilege, well, this just click the mark. Okay. Well, Atlas is offered in RFID only and RFID with fingerprint versions. Okay, that the black one is only RFID, and the green one is for RFID and fingerprint, this biometric controller. You can control 1, 2, or 4 doors, and can connect to external WiGand, OSDP, and fingerprint readers. This is the technical specifications about the Atlas. Atlas 100, Atlas 200, and Atlas 400. This is the black ones, so only have the capacity of 5,000 cardholders, 1,000 transactions, compatible with all WiGand and OSDP readers. Okay, the Atlas 160, 100, and 460, 260 series is the biometrics, so that's the difference. Only 100 or 160, 100. Okay, also we have a metal box for the Atlas Pro or Atlas Bio. For you can have more secured these controllers. So in this case, you can have the with the LEDs in the box, you can see if the controller is turned on or has some alarm, or even and you can a tamper switch with this metal box. So if you have any issue, or somebody has with no that never can get inside or manipulating this atlas, then the tamper switch can give us an alarm. Working with application. Primary secondary architecture allows scaling up to 84 doors with maximum 20 secondary devices. Okay. Support WGAN and OSDP readers. Built-in PoE capability. Advanced access control features. Mobile app available for iOS and Android platform. And the optional metal box. Atlas external readers. These are the KR61 series. These readers, we have three kinds, 610 and 611 and 612 readers. It's for standard EM cards, ID cards, MyFair and Disfire cards, and the OSDP readers. Okay, you can use the also the keyboard, numerical keyboard in the with the reader. Also, you can use the KR310 and 613 readers. These readers are a dual reader. Okay, you can use, for example, EM and MyFair cards. Also, the FRM 15000A reader. This is very important. This reader is must have the letter A at the end of the serial, because it's designed for Atlas controller. Okay. Also, with your PC, you can manage the fingerprint with the USB fingerprint reader. Okay. This is the SLK20 reader. Okay. It's just like this. This is the reader for your PC, where you can, the administrator of the system, you can register all the fingerprints. Card format flexibility. This format you can create your own if you need, for example, a corporate meal 1,000 cards, HID cards. You can select these features of, for example, facility code star, code length, where is located this code, and which beep star the parity of the security format. So also you can see this in the controller on the demo now, and an installation diagram. You can use the Atlas controller directly to a switch. For example, this switch can be a PoE switch that you can use the network cable and brings the power supply just directly with this cable. Also, the secondary controllers could be used attached with this switch too. Your PC must be in the same network, and you can use the exit button, the WGAN or OSDP reader, proximity or fingerprint or both, an electric lock, or the use that you want to use with the relay incorporated in our Atlas controller. Also, you can use an auxiliary relay output. For example, you can connect an alarm system, firefighting system, with using the linkage, you can bring this function. If you have some issue or the system was tampered, you can give the alarm signal. Okay, this is the same example for the two kind of atlas, just the RFID proximity or biometric. Okay, the only difference is the biometric controller has the fingerprint reader. Okay. Well, from our marketing, ZKTeco Europe, with the thank you for your assistance. And now we are going to make the demonstration of the system, how this works, how see the software, it's you can see it finally. I'm using Google Chrome for this the configuration of the Atlas controller. So the default IP address of our controllers always comes with the box. When we buy the Atlas controller, have a box like this, and in the side we can find a user's guide and installation guide too. Okay, and it comes with a sticker. With this sticker, you can paste it next to the controller, and you can see in a more easily way the connections of every pin on the controller. So the IP address by default is used with a standard protocol for DHCP, and this is the in the range 169.254.202.242. So when we are connected, I've changed my IP address. Okay. Well, then you can see my PC has I have connected here with a local switch, and though I don't have internet with this Atlas, but my IPv4 must have the automatically IP direction address and automatic DNS2. So I need to refresh IP address. System takes again the IPC. Well, I'm going to take the an IP from the same range. Okay. For example. So now I can reach the controller. Okay. Now this controller gives this message that it's an unsecure site because always use HTTPS, but we need to use a certificate of this site is secure. This certificate you can ask to your TI department, or you can but with the site secure site this kind of certificates. So then you can when you have this certificate of security, then you can upload to the controller, and this message is not going to prompt again. So I have just this controller before in another webinar, so I'm going to make the factory restore. Or you can see how you can use one controller of this if you change the installation, or if you are testing it, you can easily way to factory recover. Okay. Factory restore. Well, when we make the factory restore to our controller, then the all the configurations and setup that was done before going to lose it, and now the when the device reboot, then you can be able to set up this again. The credentials for the first time use is admin. Okay, this is the first screen that we have in the controller. Then you need to select the language. Okay, you have many language to you can use. Okay, so in this case we're going to use English. Next step is just for select if this controller going to be the primary or secondary. In this case we are going to take this like primary, and then next step is the name of this controller. So this controller is going to call Atlas Figures Webinar. Now the configuration. You have four types of the configuration. You can use it for in only. You can use it for in and out with readers. You can use it with in only and master point, or you can use it with in only and can enrollment point. Okay, in only you can use it in some building or office or place where you have, for example, reception where you using with an exit button is not necessary to register the users and also have the reader from internally, then you can use it in only mode. Now, if you use the controllers in some area that maybe is more security, or the way to use is with reader in and reader out, then you need to select the in-out mode. In only and master point is for a site where you can have to register and point of reunion when you have some issue or emergency mode, you can use this controller to have a reader when you can take, for example, the people that is inside of the building when you have the emergency, then they need to go out and pass the card or the code and register that they can exit and no one is inside. And the other way is in only and car enrollment point. This car enrollment point is for use the reader connected in the reader to and the controller, just for register the cards of the users. You can manage this this Atlas, and you don't need a card reader with your PC, so you can use the reader just for enrollment point. So in this case, this primary controller I'm going to set up like in out. Every controller that you use in your system, you can use one of these four modes. Okay, it's not mandatory to set up all the controllers with the same mode. These controllers you can use it like you need in every area that is going to be installed. Next settings is the time. Okay, here in Madrid is UTC plus one, so I'm going to set up the time zone. The password is the first feature that we need to change for a secure password. In this case, like we don't have registered with the controller, like I telling you before, I recommend maybe use an easy password, and then you can change it when you have the Atlas controller registered. For if you have any issue, you can recover this password. So I'm going to enter admin 1234. Okay. And like you can see, we don't have the option for see what I type. So this is why we can have some issue in the first configuration of the controller, because if we use special characters or something more secure, maybe we can type it fine, or using the caps lock or something that changes the password. And if I lose this password and I can get in again, log in again to the controller, then I can recover this password. Okay. The next step is the configuration of the network interface settings. So you can use DHCP or manually. Always in this kind of controllers or access control devices, we don't recommend using the DHCP, because maybe your router or DHCP server can assign a different or unknown IP address, and then we need to find it, and going to make more complex the way to configure the data controller again. So with the technology user information department, you can have orange in your network, and have the list of all the controllers. In this case, you can use only 21 IP address, so you can have a very low resources with this system. So in this case, I'm going to leave the default IP address for this controller. Okay, and the secondary, I have another controller here that I want to use like secondary. I'm going to give the same IP address by default plus one at the end. So this case ends with 242. The secondary that I'm going to use is in 243, for example. Okay. Also, this IP address, you can use the IP address that you have in your network like you want. Okay, it's not really needed to use exactly this kind of IP address. Now the system shows the all the setup that we have made in the previous steps, and if everything is okay, then we can complete setup. So at the end of this, the device is going to reboot, and after the reboot, the device reboots, then we can be able to log in to the controller and start to configure and set up all the features in our software. Okay, this takes a very few seconds. So one moment, our controller shows the has some LED in the front, and when the device comes again with the power LED and run and communication, it's in the linking. So we have for sure that we can reach it. Okay, so I'm going to try to log in. 1234. Okay, perfect. Now I'm into the Atlas controller and the web server. So here you have this message. Atlas series, thank you. Thank you for purchasing ZKTeco's Atlas series product. Please take a few moments to register your system. Benefits of registering: access to technical support, firmware upgrades, security enhancements, new features, ability to purchase licensed features such as additional doors or mobile apps clients, optional email notification of new available firmware upgrades, features, and services. OK, Okay, secure password, reset function, this is one we are talking at the first time, and more. Okay, so this is very, we recommend you make always the register. Okay, so it's just to create a file to fill some fields. Or if you, for example, have you are using the Atlas controllers and maybe this controller failed or you have to change it, well, you have a rescission form, so you can use it or create a new one. So the fields that you have to fill is the serial number. It's not you can change it because it's from the system. So well, the site name, users, how many doors you have, company, city, state, zip code, country or region, and first name, last name, phone number, and your email. Okay. Then you can check the communications field if you want to receive some more updates or features or services. If you are interested, well, you can select it, and then you can receive our newsletters and emails from ZK. So in this case, I know I want to register because it's for demo mode only. So here you have our controller or software. You have this is the main screen. So here the controller gives the everything is okay. The controller is online. This controller is just for it's of one door, but has two readers, so the system recognizes it like two doors. But it's door for enter, door for exit, but it's the same. Okay. Let's back up when you're going to make the automatically mode. The last backup when it was done. Active web clients in this moment. I am connected here. Then I don't have any mobile clients. Okay. Here you can see that the admin password is not secured. So if you have registered the Atlas controller and you are logged in, so you can change this password here, just clicking it, and then the user admin, okay, you can choose it, and here in password you can change. So here you can use the password secured, and you can use any password that you never can forget. So I'm not going to change, but you have here the way to change it. So let's go back to the home page. Also, I have an alert that this issue is it's not registered. So if you want to register, just click in there, and then you can register the controller. Okay. Well. Here's the events. Okay, you can see how it's working the controller. You can see successful signing in. The door mode is using biometric or card or PIN. Okay, remember in this case, like you have biometric card and PIN, because this is an Atlas 160 model. Well, you have the three modes, okay? So you can use it only biometric, only card, or only PIN. Or you can use, for example, biometric and card for more security reasons, okay? Or the three kind of the modes, okay, at the same time. Well, this is for more restricted areas, you can use it. Okay, now the controller is online, Anyway, okay, so let's see more events here. You can see all the events that we have in the controller. Well, it's going to fill this screen. Then you can use the filters. Okay, you can see new events at the top. Okay, or at the bottom. In this case, like I have many unless events, but at the top is okay. First name, last name, card number, personal ID. This is the filters when you have your users. Then you can filter all the events of this person. If you want to know which doors was used by some person especially, you can use this filter. Okay. Also, the device filter is the same way, the same use. If you have the name of the door, you can use it here, and all the events related with this door is going to be filtered and showed in this event. Okay, you can use the controller name, or the area, or location. Okay, then this event type filter is for use with all the kind of events, or just a single of these. Okay, for example, system. Well, if you can to check all the system events, or just one of these. For example, card read enrollment, or database backed up, successful signing, sign out. But this is very, very complete. Have many possibilities and options. Okay. Also, if you want to know the people that have the answers granted, okay. Even if the door already open, access denied. Okay. And in the case of the denied, you can be, for example, anti-passback is the most common. Bad biometric read, expired, user inactive. Anyway, communications, if the controller be offline or the controllers is online, reader offline, if you have any issue, well, you can filter it too. The door, okay. If you want to know how many times the access mode was locked down, or emergency unlock mode, if the doors were forced. Okay, so input output mode. Okay, it's another filter, and tamper power. Okay, this is the three of kind of alarms that we can have of the controller. For example, I can create a fake alarm here. Well, in this case, the Atlas shows that the battery has a failure, okay? Or, for example, the main power is not working. In this way, if I have an external power supply, then the battery mode should be entered here, and we have the alarm, but the controller still be online. Or if I have tampered the controller, we have a box, maybe I can open the door of the box, and then the tamper signal comes here. Okay, well, when as soon the event was restored, then the event shows here too. Okay, all the system always going to shows everything that happened here on the controller. Well, this is the part of the filters on monitoring mode. Okay, well, the monitoring mode, you can have this menu, the event that we have here. You can see all the alarms, okay? For example, tamper mode. status, door status. Okay, if we have some issue with the reader or something, then we have an offline mode. Maps, this feature we are going to see in the next config mode. You can see filter all the maps of the controllers, master points. You can see always here if you have generated some master points. Well, you can see it here in the monitoring menu. Audit, you can use it for have some report of any kind. For example, if you change database or manual commands, you want to send a manual command of the open or something like that, you can get all the reports. Okay, users by admin or for any user, okay? And the date from and to. Okay. Alarm history. Well, event history. We was see it before. Okay, all the monitoring. So you can see alarm history, user access level report. In this case, all the controller has. You can set up some access level, and you can see all the reports too. Okay. And user door report. In this case, for every door, you can generate your report and download to your PC. Okay. Well, at the access control menu, you have the users. Well, in this menu, you can create all the users. For example, all the fields that you have is very, very strong information of every user. Okay, you can use the first name, last name, create a personal ID. Okay, for example, I'm going to create a number 2, first name test, webinar. Okay, you can assign the role of the user. Okay, these roles are created by default, but you can create roles as you need. For example, cardholder only is for a user that only going to have permissions that you want. Alarm monitoring is, for example, a security person only can see the monitoring alarm. User and creation management, just for like the name says, is just for management these users or credentials. If you need to change some fingerprint or card or user data, well, the information you can select this kind of role. Basic monitoring, access control management, or system administration. You can have a super admin, and also you can create system administration users. For example, if you have an admin backup, okay, if you want to have different administration, like maybe the chief or another supervisor, well, you can create a role of system administration and can have the report of these modifications with each user. Okay, well, in this case, car holder only. User group, you can create user groups. The language of each user, this is not the language of the controller, this is the language of the person. Okay. This is valid from, for example, this person maybe has a recent incorporation of the people or the person the company. Well, you can select the date of the when this person is be able to enter in the building. So this is marked that until further notice. So you can select, for example, a person that maybe is temporary for vacations or maybe some employee was injured or something is recovered here. Well, you can create the date exactly like this person going to have the access to the system. Okay, even the hour. Okay, so you can disable this user. Okay, if you want to have this person registered in our database, but you don't want to delete the user, you can disable, and you need to delete and lose all the punches that this person has in our system. Okay, you can put the vacation from and to of this person, and when this person is in vacation mode, well, if this person want to enter in the building, well, the system not allow this, and you have a report of this. Okay, email, mobile phone, and these fields, custom fields, you can use, for example, favorite team or football or card or something else. You can change it with the admin mode. You can change these custom fields for more information about this employee. The cards, you can use multiple cards, so you can in this case, you can register here all the information of the card using the readers or using different cards for every buildings or places where we have the Atlas devices installed. Well, you can use you can create these card numbers. Yeah, I can make it manually or with a CR20 card reader for the PC, or using our readers in the system. Okay, I want to give some number, and then you have here the enroll fingerprints. If you use the fingerprint in this case, well, using the silk reader in the PC, you can register the fingerprints here. You have this case, my fingerprint is not working with my PC because it had an issue of connection, but I want to try to fix it and then show you again how to enroll these fingerprints. The PIN, you can create this PIN here using, in this case, by default is four digits, so you can change it in the admin menu if you want to create PIN with more digits for more secure options. This PIN could be used always also with the for emergency mode, for example. Okay, for duress PIN type, this duress mode, it's, for example, if some maybe the employee or the user has been has an address, it's attacked from someone else. Well, in this case, you can use the add one to last digit. For example, in this case, my PIN is 2345. Well, if I use the same PIN, but I add one to the last digit, for example, 2346. Well, the system going to register a duress mode and going to give some alarm to our system, and maybe the security person can see this alarm and could help this person, okay, this user. Or you can use an explicit dual spin. Okay, this is another number different from the axis pin. Example, the pin reverse. Okay, this is one that the administrator wants to use. It's your decision. Okay, this privilege. In this case, for example, just extend your door times. Maybe one door could be open for just 5 seconds, and maybe this person needs to maybe it's coming with a boxes or furnishing or something and need more time with this privilege. You don't want to have an alarm, okay? Because this person have the extended door times privilege. Anti-passback exempt. Okay, for example, if you have the anti-passback installed in your system, if you enter in some area, you can't enter in again if you are not exit registered. Okay, so with this privilege, this person can enter and exit even if not have registered the exit when has an previous entering. Okay, access doors in no access mode. For example, you have a lockdown mode, okay, or the door is not allowed to be accessed. With this privilege, you can access in every door. Okay, and the same happens with the lockdown mode. If you have some problem in the building or the building are closed and you don't want to give access to anybody, well, you with this privilege you can enter into the building even with the lockdown mode. And allow first credential unlock. This first credential unlock is used, for example, in cases that maybe it's a special day and no one is coming here and there's no one, a lot of traffic of people. Well, all the doors stay maintain open until this person punch his card again. Okay, well, with this privilege you can use it this function. Now the access levels, in this case you can add, well, when you have created it, restricted areas or special areas or all the areas you can give the permissions to this person. Or if this person is just for cleaning the building, well, with only you can bring access to the special area where this person can be get inside. Okay, door access, the is something the same that access levels, but door access is just for a special door. Okay, in an access levels you can create a group of doors. But and door access is specifically for each door, okay? And the card design. The card design is for the cards. If you want to use the printer mode or a car printer, well, you can see the front of the card and the back. Also, if you have registered the design of the card of each user, well, you can compare this car with the car presented with this by this person. Okay. Well, as you can see, have many options the user's identity in the field, all the fields. So I have created this user. So now I have test webinar that with the personal ID number 2 and well, all the users that I want to create after this, well, must be created with the same way. You can you will need to click here, create, and after you filled all the fields, then you need to save this change. Also, if you want to delete some user, you need to select it, and you can use the button, delete button. Okay, the system always going to ask if you want to delete, or maybe it's a mistake. So I'm going to cancel it. So now we are going to shared access codes. Shared access code, it's for many kind of users or a group that you want to not have personal codes. Well, you can use these shared codes. Emergency codes, this is for the administrators or security or the people that must have to have these codes in case of if this would need it. Well, you can create the emergency codes here too. Okay, you can use every access label or door access. Is not this emergency codes. It's not mandatory to open all the system. Only if you want to open special areas, well, you can select it, and these codes are going to open only the areas that you have created. Okay. Access labels. Here you can choose all the controllers and doors that you want to create in these access labels, and after this you can use, for example, every door all the time or on a special schedule. So this feature is also here available. The schedules, okay, I'm just cut here. Schedules, you can create also schedules for every building, every door, every system. Okay, you can create it here with time zones, all the days, weekdays, weekend, special days, vacations, and you have all the possibilities. Now, door mode schedules. Well, this schedules, you can use it for each user or for all the system, or you can use it in door mode. Okay, for example, maybe the entrance door only should be used in work time. Well, you can use an door mode scale, for example. Special days, it's holiday days in every country or every place that you need. Well, you can create it here, selecting day by day. Okay. Multi-user access. This multi-user access is for the users that can get in and with how can I tell you? For example, you have the director's area or the cleaning area or tal. Okay, you can use it here. You can bring the name of the number of users, so you can create it this and assign to this the users who can be using these options. Okay. Now, configuration. Okay, here we are going to use the other controller. So in this screen only shows the first controller, that is the primary controller. In this case I'm going to use an Atlas. This is for two doors. This Atlas 200. Okay, this is not biometric, but we can mix it with the biometric controllers or not. I'm going to plug in my controller. Well, here we can set up all the features of our controllers. We can change the name of the main controller. We can disconnect with the network. Okay, always going to give us the status of each controller, serial number, firmware version, which configuration have this controller, where it's located. Okay, the language of each controller. This is the language of the controller. Okay, and which doors are connected to this controller. In this case, we have two doors. Okay, this is the same door relay, but we have two modes, in and out. Okay, in the in door, you can create this. Remember this door one and door one out is the readers. Okay, it's named like door, but really is the readers. So we can create templates for the doors, and you can activate or disable the manual commands in each door. So you can select the mode of work of this door. For example, the most simple is biometric or card or PIN, or you can mix it and use, for example, biometric and PIN, or biometric and card, only biometric, and disable the cards and PIN. So you can use any of these combinations. If you want to use an scale, well, you can select it here and establish in this case. Multi-user access, you can permit or not. Time unlock time, in this case the default time is 5 seconds. So the door is and the relay door is going to be open just for 5 seconds. After that, the door must be closed. If you don't close the door, then you're going to have in the next 10 seconds a pre-alarm warning time. If the door maintain open, then you're going to have a held open alarm. Okay, and then in the next 30 seconds, and this door still be open, then you're going to have the alarm of the open was always open. So these times you can change it, you can use, for example, the extended unlock time and extended held time. You can for the user's privilege, you can give, for example, not just the first seconds. You can use in the extended unlock time maybe 200 seconds. Okay, so this is the features that you can modify with each door. You can suppress the exit button events. So if you use the exit button, not always going to have in the reports an event for every time that you press that button. You can disable the unlock with the exit button, even if somebody connect an exit button. If you had disabled this option, you can be able to open this door with this function. The relock on is this option. This feature is for example, you can relock the door at the end of the unlock time. Okay, in this case should be 5 seconds, or you can select door open. As soon the door were open, then the door must be relocked. So if you open the door and you close it, the time is not going to work. Okay. As soon and this controllers also have a door sensor. So as soon this sensor knows that the door was closed, well, you should be locked and at that moment. Okay, not going to take time because maybe this door is could be maintained open maybe 10 minutes. Well, no problem. As soon the door was closed, the sensor detects that the door will close, then you should be use a tag or a card or the PIN or the mode that you have selected for this door to open it again. Door close or end of unlock time. So this is a mix of this for these two options. Okay. Well, the most common is unlock time. Well, exempt from global lockdown. You can exempt for example, if the door is a site, a communication site, well, you can exempt this door from global lockdown or emergency unlock, because this is an restricted area, and maybe the people not should be there. So you can give this privilege. Now, the areas and anti-passback. Here you can select, the entering area, you activate with the global out. For example, once you have entered in some area, you need to out in general, global out. Okay. Now, you can do this with some area, special area. So, and this is managed with the global out. The other way, anti-passback method. You can base it area-based or dot-based. In the area-based, maybe you can, in this area, you can have maybe six doors. Well, if you enter to the area with the door one, you can exit with the door three. The anti-passback going to know that you have exit of the area, so the next time that you want to enter, the access control going to allow this going to permit that you can enter in again, because it's based within an area. Now, if the door based is activated in this case, if you enter to some area with the door one and you want to exit with the door two, if you don't make the punch with the door two and door one exit, then you're going to be locked by the anti-passback. Okay, so this normally we use area based only, door based is with only one way and one door to one way. You can only get in with the same door. So, well, this is very important when you select it. So, you can grant access or deny access. This is it depends of the way that you permit or not. The administration have the think it how it's going to work this mode. So you have all these options. When you change every single field, you can create a template, and then you don't need to fill these fields again one by one. You can use this template, and all the doors that you need to use in the same way, well, it's more easily using templates. Okay. I'm going to leave in the default mode. So this is, for example, just door one in, but we have the door one out. So maybe one door can be used in one way and the other in different. So I recommend always use door templates. Okay. Well, the time is coming up, so I want to be going more faster from here. We have locations. In locations, we can create a region or country, or you have the campus, building, floor, room. This is just by administrative purposes. Areas, the same way. Like we had, for example, global out, well, you can create a different, and should be named that like you want. Location, if you have created, for example, campus, principal campus, where if you want to create a, this is just for on the passback options, basically. You can use it global or local mode, managed by the Atlas primary or secondary. Well, in this case, I only have one controller, so I don't have more options. Airlock mode, no exit during entry, a strict single door. So this is the options of the passback mode. We have the maps. We can create maps specifically with every Atlas controller. So you can create a map with the, using a, for example, Google Maps, and establish the exact location of the controllers. Card designs. In this menu, you can create your own design of the identifications. Okay, so you can use the fields like you want to use in your cards, text, image, background. Well, this is just for the design of the cards. Card formats. In this case, it's just for the Wigan readers, all the Wigan readers. Okay, this format cards is for specifically cards that maybe HIV cards or something that you need, not cards sold by GK. Maybe you can buy these cards with another supplier, so you must need a specifically card format. Well, you can create here with the information specifically for these cards. Okay, that with this format, then the Atlas controller should be capable to recognize these cards. User groups. I was talking before of this, and you can create, for example, a loose first credential, administration, or cleaning people. This is the user groups. Alarm triggers, if you have a door forced open, the rest with a person, maybe attack, emergency code present. What's going to do the controller in this case? How is going to be the event going to be shown in the reports? Door templates. You can manage the door templates here. If you have created maybe 10 different kind of templates of the doors, well, you can modify here. When you have created this template door, you can modify it in each door. You must be the administrator and manage here. Okay. Well, hardware templates, it's the same thing. You can create, and with the configuration of the controllers, you can create templates too. So you don't need to create one by one. Okay. In the controllers hardware, you have the reader, how is this reader is going to work. Maybe you can use an OSDP reader. You select the ZKTeco model. But if you want to use Wigan, for example, you can use a custom. So also you can use the reader's OSDP. What is you going to select the reader type? Okay, if you have Wigan, for example, you can select if this reader has the keypad or not, like this, for example. And if have this reader has the just green LED or green and red LED for the when you pass the card. Well, you have the LEDs. You can mix it. You can use, for example, in the for the door in, you can use a Wigand and exit RS45, or you can use it Wigand in boat, or whatever you want, you can use it here. Here you have the inputs, okay? You have the AC fail, battery fail, the brake. In this case, it's named brake, but this is the tamper auxiliary in the alarm, okay? You can enable just sticking with these options, okay? Or disable, but you have the tick or not. Then you can use it in normally open or normally closed mode. This releases the two ways mode. You have also the auxiliary in 1 and 2. All the controllers always going to have an auxiliary in. For example, an emergency mode button or lockdown button. In this case, for address or if it be robbery, this the building or something like that, you can use these two kinds of auxiliary and make some linkage. This linkage is going to be enabled here. You can use, for example, lockdown, okay? And the other auxiliary, you can select, for example, the emergency unlock. Okay, this is an example. And another way, you can use it by door, and you can maybe create the relay momentary. It's these options is just with features. We can select nothing else. It's these two options. If this auxiliary be managed by the primary controller, or this is managed by door. Okay. You have the auxiliary out. In this case, you can connect a fire alarm or another system that you have this linkage, or a light, or I don't know, a strobe. Well, you can manage it by door. And these conditions, then you can be used, okay? Or this maybe can be managed with the controller, main controller. So, for example, this is a tamper. So, in this case, if the main controller be managed when you had a tamper, you can use the pulse or with some time, okay? Or you can maintain this signal. For example, this is with the fire alarm. Well, you mostly use the tamper condition and the toggle, okay? During all the time that this link should be activated by the controller, it's going to be open this auxiliary out. Now the lock one, in this case, is like his name says, is you set for the door. You can change the way to use the lock of the door. Always this exit and this output going to be used with the readers. Okay. Well. This is all the configuration. Now, in the admin menu, we have the user roles. Okay, this roles is by default. Well, and you can create here the roles that you need, just selecting the options to be used with this kind of users. Okay. And this is the privilege that is going to have this role. You have here the backup and restore options. In this case, it is enabled by default a daily backup at 0 hours and 24 hours. So you can change here if you want to make it daily or weekly or monthly. These controllers has an USB port in the controller, so you can have an USB drive, a pen drive connected to the controller, and with this option, all the automatically backups going to make it created in the USB. You can create a manual backup, and while you click this button, at this moment, you have created a backup complete and download it to the PC where is managed the controller. Here you have the three backups that are always going to be stored by the controller in automatically mode if you don't use the USB drive, for example. Well, in the internal memory, you can have these three backups. So if you want to recover and store backup, you just need to select it and restore, for example. Or if you have some file in your PC, well, you have to browse it and select, and then when you select the correct file, then you can restore, okay? This is very important. In this controller's Atlas, you can use a backup from another controller. These backups are encrypted, and you just can use this with the own controller, okay? System settings. In this case is notifications, events in databases. It's just management of the fields and events, or you want how long you want to have the databases, okay? The custom fields with the users template. Well, you can change the names here, okay? Favorite food, car, or something like that, or whatever you want. Here you can change the length of the PIN codes. Okay, by default, this four numbers, the four digits, the PIN codes, you can change it here. Okay, the number of the card numbers. Normally, it's just decimal card numbers, but if you want to use hexadecimal, well, you can change it here. Network. Well, in this case, this controller only has the Ethernet option. If you have the Wi-Fi controller, well, you can set up the network parameters here. Date and time. You can have these controllers connected in different places, and you can select the time zone for each controller. Okay, and also you can set server time to current browser, for example. My PC, it's have to change the time if this were different. Well, in this case, it's the same, but or you can use NTP servers, for example. Email settings. In this case, you can use this is just an example. It's not working, but you can activate this option and have the notifications of the password, the Atlas controller. Okay, well, this is where you have to perform these options. Achieve downloads. Well, if you have some files downloaded and that, well, in this case, this is the site where it's going to be reported. Firmware settings. Here you have the options for making an upgrade firmware, okay, and make a factory reset or reboot the controllers. If you want to reboot the controller manually, you can enter it to the controller and come here and reboot it. Web server settings. In this case, you use the web server port is 443. You can change it like you want, or that your TI department provides you. Okay, certificate of HTTPS secured. Remember, when you have this event, well, this is why, because we don't have a validate certificate. Communications. In this case, the secondary controllers connect back to primary, okay, or you can secondary controllers connect back to primary at alternate. Maybe in your network, if any controller can reach the primary, then you can give the options. If you can reach the primary, talk with another secondary, or the secondary talks first with the other secondary and then with the primary. This is just communications options. Here you have the options of the mobile devices. This is for the mobile app. Well, you have to create a user. So in this case, I'm going to create a test. If you don't want to have some issues, I recommend create 1 day before the user valid from, because sometimes in the same day maybe not allowed to use it. Okay, you can disable it with some special time or until further notice. Okay, when you save it, you have created this user, and then you have the QR code that you have to read with your mobile phone or the device, mobile device that you have installed the application. Well, this is all the menus and options of the ZK Atlas Series controllers. In this side, you have the lockdown button. From here, you can close all the system. Example, it's an emergency lockdown. At this moment, all the system goes to close, and until you clear the lockdown, then the device, the system will be performed on the lockdown. So you can clear lockdown here, okay, and then the system working normally again. Of course, the alarms will be created, okay, when you have the, for example, the tamper. The first time I make it manually, and now the global access mode lockdown. Now we can take the ask time, and well, if you want to ask something, I'm going to give you the microphone on at this moment. Okay, now you can talk if you want to share something or ask something. You have some doubt. Does you have any doubt, somebody? Well, if you don't have any questions or doubts or something, thank you for your assistance, and we will glad to helping you if you have any issue. Remember, this is a very powerful tool, very great device, and we are here for everything that you need. Have a nice day and nice weekend.